ladies and gents, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and welcome back to the third instalment of PMT's Behind the Scenes vlog. A vlog where I show you behind the scenes, a backstage pass to PMT, more specifically PMT Newcastle. And we've had a lot of fun in the past. We've been doing handstands whilst changing strings.
You've got this.
We've watched Jordan eat a banana in slow motion. And played some jazz through one of the most metal amps of all time. But in this video, I feel like we need to be a bit more sophisticated and bring some sophistication to the world of rock and roll. I'm just kidding. Rock and roll is supposed to be fun, and we can't wait for you guys to come back to our lovely PMT stores. There's light at the end of the tunnel, and I'm going to document us merchandise in the stores and unboxing some very cool guitars, which I'll be doing today in this vlog, as well as showing you guys a 2-minute tone tip on how to do a dive bomb. But for now, let's show you some goodies from the video room. So this week, the guitars that I've been shooting with. First off, the Kramer Focus VT122. This is the budget guitar from Kramer. It's about 100 quid and it's utterly fantastic. Stay tuned for that. The Noventa Jazzmaster video will be going live, or will be live right now, as is the Tracy Guns Gunstar Voyager interview with Tracy and demo of this guitar. I adore this so damn much.
We got cool guitars.
Inspired by Gibson, Les Paul Classic, and the studio down here on the deck. Fantastic guitars from the fine folk at Gibson. It's more than just a new headstock on these Inspired by Gibsons. They're fantastic. Oh yeah, and the Noventa Strat bringing up the rear here. So those are the goodies you get to check out if you get your fine selves subscribed to PMTVUK on YouTube. However, downstairs here at PMT Newcastle, I've been told that there's been a Gibson delivery, and who doesn't love a bit of Gibson? How's it going, gents? You alright? There he is, Mr. Handstand himself. Everyone watching PMTVUK, go over to you and Clemenson's social media channels and cheer him on for whatever the CrossFit Games is.
Absolutely.
What are you laughing at? You can't say it. Why can't you say it? It's something about... So it looks like the lads are nice and busy today, which is a nice change for them. Nah, not really there. They're always busy setting up guitars and sending them out for you fine folk. Let me just angle this. YouTube viewers love unboxings, and I have lots of these to show you guys. I'm just going to show you one or two, because why the devil not? I can see what it is on the top, but I'm not going to show you guys what it is. Just for the record as well, they do usually work. It's me that comes down, I was like, do a handstand. So they do usually work. For any of my bosses watching, that's just the disclaimer. The iconic brown Gibson Tolec case. I'm so pleased they brought these black back. The black ones are cool, but this is awesome. So let's see what's inside. Look at that. This is a 60s Les Paul Standard in Tobacco Sunburst. One of the most iconic finishes of all time. It's just slash, isn't it? Mahogany body, set mahogany neck, and that beautiful flame maple top. This thing is absolutely amazing. Let's see how she sounds. 2 seconds. Look how nice this case is inside. They used to be pink. I think the custom shop ones are still pink, but it's a beautiful red velvet interior. Gibson strap. The photograph of said guitar in Gibson's workshop getting set up. And a little goodie bag filled with Gibson, what I assume to be, goodies. And a blank truss rod cover, because that one that comes with says standard. Look at this glorious thing. Fantastic guitar. Gibson are knocking it out the park these days. 50s and 60s spec Les Paul standards. This is the 60s spec with the flame maple top. It plays and sounds as good as it looks, and damn does it look good. I'm using the trusty Blackstar JJ and 20 head and cab as well. It's mint. I was told earlier that we received some camouflage Fender gig bags, but all I can see is this grey one. I don't think we've got any camouflage ones. Comment down below if you would buy or can see a camouflage one. Let's unbox something else, one of my favourite guitars. It's not a Gibson. It's kind of a Gibson, but it's not really a Gibson. You can already tell by the headstock what this guitar is. Black, gold hardware. Love a good unboxing. unsheath it. Look at that. Ta-da! This is a glorious thing. The Inspired by Gibson Epiphone Les Paul Custom. Now, Epiphone Les Paul Customs have been around for a number of years, but never quite like this. So when you guys see one of the new Inspired by Les Paul Customs, don't just assume that it's a new headstock. This is the closest thing you can get to a real deal Les Paul Custom. It's utterly fantastic, and Epiphone have knocked it right out of the park.
Yes.
How's your sandwich?
Good.
Did you say someone rang up asking if we sell wine racks?
Wine racks.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been asked what we sell? Stop calling, they're very busy at work.
A sledge.
Right, the sledge story.
Yeah, the weirdest thing I ever got asked for was a sledge. So when we had a bit of snow, a month ago was it? This phone goes, I'm like, PMT Newcastle, Jordan speaking. It doesn't even say hello. He goes, you got any sledges? So I'm like, what? Like, trying to, you know, be pro and everything. Sorry, is that a brand? You know, for the kids. What? we're an instrument retailer, we don't do sledges. Do you actually mean sledges for the snow? Yep. Right, okay. Let's go to Argos then, mate, sorry. Well, I didn't know what to say, I was taken off guard. I was like, what?
My craziest thing is paracetamol or lighters.
You got any paracetamol? I need a light down.
Paracetamol, are you joking?
We're next to the quayside here in Newcastle, and lots of stag do's and hen do's come past, knock on the window, and not only say I look like Russell Brand, but also want paracetamol and lighters from a music store for some peculiar reason. Anyways, back to the music at hand, I'm going to show you guys a little tone tip, how to do an Eddie Van Halen Dimebag Darrel style dive bomb.
Maybe they'll have some paracetamol here. Excuse me, mate. Have you got any painkiller? Christ, I was only asking.
It's one of the funnest things you can do on a guitar with a Floyd Rose. I'd highly recommend using a Floyd Rose because it's a locking tremolo. And once you hammer the bar, you don't want your guitar to go out of tune. You want it to return perfectly to pitch, as it does with a Floyd Rose. This fine example is a PRS Vernon Reed signature, the guy from Living Colour, his signature PRS guitar. It's got a V-shaped profile neck, it's all gold, and it's got some quirky stickers on the scratch plate. But most importantly, it's got a Floyd Rose for doing stuff like this on. As soon as I pick up a guitar with a Floyd Rose, a dive bomb is the second or third thing I do on it, besides just going, yeah, it works. And to do a dive bomb, there's a few different ways in which you can approach it, okay? First, you've got to find some natural harmonics. Now, they're different to pinch harmonics. Pinch harmonics are the usual. Natural harmonics are occur when you tap. You just gently rest your finger on the fret of the guitar, so not actually the note. The actual bit of metal in between the notes. They're easiest found on the 12th fret because that's an octave of the open note. But if you want to rock some cool dive bombs, the best place to find these natural harmonics for dive bombs are the D, G, and B strings, 7th, 5th, and 3rd fret, okay? And there's a couple of different ways you can do it. You can pick them, like the Eddie Van Halen Mick Mars way. I think the intro to Dr. Feelgood. Or you can do it the absolutely crackers way, the Dimebag Darrel way. And the way Dime explains it is to let her fall, catch her, and then bring her back up. And what he means by that is, don't use your pick, keep it in your hand for later. Flick the string with your left hand. In this case, the G string. Let her fall to drop the bar. This is all happening very quickly. And then just tap that fret itself around about where I showed you before to get the natural harmonic, okay? So when the bar is at its lowest, the strings are nice and flappy, so it's easier to hit said harmonic. Then you can go absolutely crackers with it, like Dime had his bar backwards and went mad with it. The elusive one, though, is the second fret on the G string. That's the most intense. Proper Dimebag Darrel school there. And that's how to do a dive bomb. Thank you for joining me today, ladies and gents, for today's behind the scenes look at PMT. Lockdown is nearly over. Hopefully we'll get you guys back in the store very soon, and I'm going to document us getting the store ready for you guys. So be sure to be subscribed to PMTVUK, not just for these ridiculous vlogs, but for lots of cool guitar and music related content. As always, if you want any more information on any of the amazing products I've spoke about here today, get your fine self to PMTonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. Thank you to Shure as well for letting me use the MV88 Plus microphone, a studio stereo condenser mic I can plug into my phone. That was a lot of fun, guys. See you next week. Have a good one.